We begin our look at the four ways that air is induced to rise by looking at orographic lifting, when air rises up and over a mountain. This is the one I'm going to spend the most time on because this is the one I'm going to apply the math to. This diagram is a mountain. What's going to happen is this. Air is going to run into the mountain. It obviously cannot go through the mountain, so it's going to rise up and over the mountain. As you're going to see, this diagram is going to get increasingly complicated. I just put two words on here, windward and leeward. The windward side of a mountain is the side that faces the prevailing winds. Prevailing means the way the winds usually blow. As a result of this, the windward side is the wet side of a mountain, because the air is rising along the windward side. Rising air is cooling air, with cooling air relative humidity is going up. Therefore, the windward side tends to be the side that gets clouds. Clouds produce precipitation. Additionally, the windward side also tends to be the vegetated side. The backside of the mountain is called the leeward side. You can see that the air descends on the leeward side. As the air is descending, it's warming. Warming air means dropping relative humidity. The leeward side is a side that's sheltered from the prevailing winds. Because of this, the leeward side tends to be the dry side. In fact, in many places, the leeward side tends to be a desert, as it definitely is in California. The leeward side is also referred to sometimes as the rain shadow, or the side of the mountain in the rain shadow, indicating that it does not get a lot of precipitation. Again, leeward and rain shadow both are going to indicate dry or a desert. So I just drew a blue line onto our diagram. As the air rises, its temperature is going to drop. And if you remember, when air temperature is going down, relative humidity is going up. This is called rule number two. The decreasing air temperature is going to result in increasing air temperature and, I mean, increasing relative humidity. Excuse me, made a little mistake there. And if you can drop the air temperature to the dew point temperature, the air will be saturated, the relative humidity will be 100%, and at that point, a cloud's going to begin to form. There's the clouds. How about that? That blue line is what's called the condensation level. This is the elevation at which a rising parcel of air first cools to its dew point temperature. So as the air is rising, it's cooling, the relative humidity is going up. The condensation level represents the elevation at which that rising parcel of air first reaches 100% relative humidity. The air is saturated, air temperature, dew point temperature, same number. From that point on, as the air rises, a cloud's going to form. I just put some elevations on here because we're going to do a math problem. On the bottom left-hand side, you can see zero, which is sea level. Then you can see now, you know, the condensation level in the case of this problem is 6,000 feet on the windward side of the mountain. The top of the mountain is 11,000 feet high. And then if you take a look over on the right-hand side, you can see that there's a leeward side valley at 3,000 feet. Now I put a temperature on there, 72 degrees. Our math problem is almost ready to go. So what's going to happen is this. The air, or an air parcel, at 72 degrees in sea level is going to begin to rise up the sides of this mountain. It will reach its condensation level at 6,000 feet, continue to rise to 11,000 feet, and then descend into the leeward valley at 3,000 feet. We need to figure out which rates we're going to use to calculate temperature change in this vertically moving air parcel. Well, from sea level up to 6,000 feet on the windward side, is there a cloud forming? No. And when the air rises and there's no cloud forming, the relative humidity is less than 100%. And under that circumstance, we use the DAR to calculate temperature change, 5.5 degrees Fahrenheit per 1,000 feet. Then, from 6,000 feet up to 11,000 feet, well, is there a cloud forming? The answer is yes. If there's a cloud forming, the relative humidity is 100%. So which rate do we use? The WAR, 3.3 degrees Fahrenheit per 1,000 feet. Excellent. Now, the air is going to descend from 11,000 down to 3,000 feet. Every time the air subsides, which rate do we use? Every time. Answer is DAR. Okay, in the next video, we do the math.